Good day. Welcome to Knowledge is Power with Dom Brown. Okay, so remember in April when I was talking about Title 35, which gives our current governor, Tom Wolf, his power under this emergency order of the disaster, okay? So remember back then I read, it says grants by the governor, okay? This is section 7305 of Title 35. Okay, so it reads, grants by governor. To implement subsection, the governor is authorized to make grants to meet disaster-related necessity, expenses, or serious needs of individuals or families adversely affected by a major disaster declared by the president. Any grant shall not exceed the amount authorized by the Robert T. Stanford Disaster Relief and Emergency Assistance Act or by applicable state law to an individual family in a single major disaster, okay? So that's, of course, after the governor declares an emergency, a state of emergency, a declaration of disaster, okay? So then it also says in section 7304, community disaster loans, okay? Whenever at the request of the governor, the president has declared a major disaster to exist in this Commonwealth, the governor is authorized upon determining that a political subdivision of this Commonwealth will suffer a substantial loss of tax and other revenues from a major disaster and has demonstrated a need for financial assistance to perform its governmental functions, to apply to federal government on behalf of the political subdivision for a loan and to receive a disperse that proceeds of any approval loan to the applicant political subdivision, okay? So basically what that reads, and it says individual and family assistance grants, okay? That's 7305, okay? Section A and section B, okay? Upon determining the assistance under the Robert T. Stanford Disaster Relief and Emergency Act, Public Law 93-288, 42 U.S.C., okay, and from other means of insufficient to meet the disaster relief necessary for expenses and serious need to individuals and their families adversely affected by a major disaster to accept a grant from the federal government for the purpose of meeting the expenses needs of disaster victims, subject to any terms and conditions imposed upon the grant. To enter into an agreement with the federal government or any federal agency or officer pledging the Commonwealth to participate in the funding of the assistance authorized in paragraph one. And if Commonwealth funds are not otherwise available to the governor, to accept an advance of Commonwealth share from the federal government, repay when the Commonwealth is unable to do so. Okay, so right there, when the governor makes these edicts and close these businesses down and affect the families of the Commonwealth, he is supposed to come up with a grant program, okay? Basically, because the families in the Commonwealth are in need. You didn't close down the businesses. You didn't made a stay-at-home order. So, okay, so if you close the business down and people lost their jobs, of course, what are you going to give in return? Because they lost their revenue, okay? So they may be in risk of losing their home, their cars, their can't pay their bills. So what do you do? As the governor, he's supposed to, according to this, Title 35, he's supposed to apply for money from the federal government. That's if Pennsylvania don't currently have money available. If Pennsylvania currently have money available, he allocated, make the grant programs, and then he applied for a repayment from the federal government. Okay, so our current President Trump did not shut down Pennsylvania. Our governor shut down Pennsylvania. So do so under his own titles in the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, it has a procedure he's supposed to follow, which he did not, okay? So that has nothing to do with wearing masks. All it had to do with him shutting down the state of Pennsylvania, okay? Deciding who should or should not be open, okay? So if he says, okay, I'm going to use this as an example. Okay, too easy workout, you cannot be open. So then I should have an option, because I'm the owner of Too Easy Workout, to say, okay, I want like a grant program. I would like to apply for this grant program or these monies, because now my employees, I'd lay off my employees, okay, or my business may go under. So it says for individuals or families, okay? So one can say, okay, it's not for businesses. Okay, so say you're an individual that worked for a business that was shut down due to the pandemic. So now you can't pay your rent, you can't pay your mortgage, you can't pay your utilities, can't pay your car note, can't pay your car insurance. Okay, what do you do? Guess what? Individuals or families. So guess what? You can apply as an individual for this disaster relief grant, or as a family for this disaster relief grant. But which he still hasn't put in place. So this is your governor, and you're not holding him accountable. Okay, so people need to hold him accountable. Okay, so hey, it is what it is. I've read The Inherited Rights of Mankind. I've read Political Powers. Political Power says the voter has the power, not the person that you elect. Okay, and then bail, fines, and punishment, special criminal tribunes. The special criminal tribunes, basically, it says you cannot single someone out. So basically, when you single these businesses out by giving them fines, it's against the policy that's declared of rights, declaration of rights. It's against their own policy. So, and I've read this in April when it started happening, but I guess people forgot. So one of my buddies asked me to reread it. So it says, special criminal tribunes. No commission shall issue creating special temporary criminal tribunes to try particular individuals or particular classes of cases, okay? So then it says bails, fines, and punishments. Excessive bail should not be required, nor excessive fines imposed, nor cruel punishment inflicted. So you give these businesses fines to close them down, but if they're closed down, how are they gonna pay the fines? That seems like excessive fines. But hey, right here in black and white, this was written way before I was born, okay? I'm just reading what's in here, okay? So you guys can take it with a grain of salt, do what you want to do with it. You know, the press, they can hold them accountable, but I seriously doubt it, you know? So, hey, it is what it is. But so remember, guys, be mentally strong, do the research, you know? Be physically strong. You woke up every day, you're physically strong. Be socially strong. You know, be sociable like we are now. Agree to disagree. Have a conversation. Have an opinion. And spiritually strong. No matter what you believe in it strongly. Until next time, guys. Peace. I love you, America. I'm out. It's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire.